Hello, my friend. My name is Pastor Stephen Adegoke of Gospel Pentecostal Assembly, the Living Word, based in Leeds. I hope you had a fantastic weekend. I bring good tidings to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you for joining me this week in the Word of the Lord. And over the weekend, the Lord has been helping me to understand two particular scenarios, two particular words in the life of a very particular person that I think I want to share with you this week, that will channel your life, that will help you to grow in the grace and into the maturity that the Lord God wants you to grow. And that is the person of Barnabas. And I want to take my Bible reading from the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 4, verse 32 to 37. Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 4, verse 32 to 37. I read, it says, "All the believers were one in heart and mind. No one claimed that any of their possessions was their own, but they shared everything they had. With great power, the apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. And God's grace was so powerfully at work in them all, that there was no needy person among them. For from time to time, those who owned land or houses sold them, brought the money from the sales, and put it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to anyone who had need." Now this is where I'm going, verse 36 and 37. It says, "Joseph, a Levite from Cyprus, whom the apostles called Barnabas, which means son of encouragement, sold a field he owned and brought the money and put it at the apostles' feet." Now, this is a very young man that I feel the Lord is speaking to someone listening to me this morning. I want to pick two things in the life of Barnabas that struck my heart and that the Lord is using to speak to you this week. These were the time where the power of the Holy Ghost came on the apostles after Jesus Christ had died, after they had received the Holy Ghost, after they began to speak in tongues, after God added 3,000 souls to them. And you know, by the time the congregation began to increase, and the Bible recorded in this passage in book of Acts of Apostles chapter number 4 from verse 32 to 37, that everyone that had amongst those people that had actually given their lives to Christ, they began to sell their stuff, began to sell their property, they began to sell their things and bringing them to the apostles' feet so that they can share among themselves those people that do not have, that people would not know that they do not have. And those people that had and they had sold, they all had everything equally. This was the practice at the time. And this is the catch about this young man. Have you wondered why he's the first person? He was the first person that was mentioned actually. His name was the first person that was actually mentioned after they had sold their property, after every one of them has been selling. But the Bible is trying to refer us to his lifestyle and telling us what made him so different. And the Bible wants us to understand his own personal lifestyle so that we can learn and emulate this good virtue in the life of Barnabas. All right. The number one thing that Lord wants us to understand in this week as we're going is sacrifice. Just as every other person amongst those people that were there with the apostles sold their properties, sold their land, sold their stuff and gave it to the apostles so that they can all share. And the Bible said he sold his own piece of land also and brought it. What is that thing that you have that you think without what you have, the church, the group you belong to, your neighbor, your friend, they will not succeed without you? God is telling you, there are other people that are doing it, but God wants you to do yours as well. God wants you to play your part. God wants you to sacrifice that which is in your hand. And I think the Lord is speaking to you this morning also. As you are going this week, there are going to be so many advances, so many opportunities for you to express your sacrificial heart to God this week. I don't want you to hold on to that thing that you don't want to release. I don't want you to hold on to the sacrifice that you think that is what is sustaining your life. No, that's not what is sustaining your life. God can do with every other person that is bringing their sacrifice, just like there are other people that were selling their properties here and bringing their resources to the apostle so that they can share among themselves. So also there are other people that are helping to lift the gospel to the world. There are other people that are propagating the gospel of Christ to the world. There are other people that are giving hands to people. There are other people that are blessing souls. There are other people that are interceding. But what is that thing that you have? What is your intercessory hour that God is asking you to sacrifice? Give that hour to me and pray and intercede for pastors and intercede for members and intercede for your family and intercede for your friend. Pray for them. Pray for the sick. God is asking you to sacrifice. God asked Abraham to sacrifice and he didn't think twice. He sacrificed. He wanted to give his son. He was willing to give his son. God himself gave an example of sacrifice. He sent his son, Jesus. That is why the Bible says, for as many as have received him, to them he gave the power to become the sons and daughters of God. God is laying something in your heart to live this week, to sacrifice this week. Beloved, I want to tell you, for you to see God in action, you have to have a sacrificial heart. And another thing I want to share with you that this young man did that was so spectacular, he defended. What did he defend? He defended, there was a very young brother, Brother John. He also called Mark in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 13 and verse 13, and also Acts chapter 15, verse number 36 to 41. The Bible says there is this young man, he's called John also. He was among those people that were going with Paul and Barnabas to preach the gospel in Pamphylia. And in Acts chapter 13, verse 13, the Bible recorded that this John Mark, so-called, is John and also called Mark, and he decided to turn back. He said he was not going to go with Paul and Barnabas anymore. And Paul didn't say, okay, follow me. They didn't force him. Barnabas didn't force him. But at the time, this guy realized that, oh, okay, for some reason, maybe they met somewhere. How they met wasn't recorded, but they met in the book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter number 15. They met, and Paul said, you are not going to come with us. We are going to preach again. We are going for another missionary journey, but you are not going to come with us. But look at what Barnabas did. Barnabas said, no, he has to follow us. He has to come with us. For whatever reason why he left us at the first missionary journey where we want to go, for whatever reason, but this time he has come. He said he wants to follow us. Let us allow him. He's our brother. He's our brother. And this is the fact. How many brethren that have probably left or probably, you know, decided not to do the work of the ministry with you, and you are still there standing, and they have decided to come back, or probably they have met with God, or probably they have been regenerated, or probably they have been revived. They have seen the need for the gospel to spread more, and they have come to you. What are you doing? Are you pushing them away? Are you saying, oh, you are a sinner, oh, you have gone to the wall, God doesn't need you anymore? Is that what you're saying? God is talking to someone this morning. If you have the opportunity this week, welcome them. Embrace them. Defend them. Tell the kingdom of darkness that we are winning and that we are marching on. No gate of hell will prevail. This young man, Barnabas, defended John. He defended this man. Who are you defending this week? Or do you have that mind to defend your fellow brother, your fellow sister, your fellow neighbor? Have that mind today. Two things. This is the kind of life a believer should lead. Number one, you have to be sacrificial at heart. And number two, you have to be defensive when it comes to the body of Christ. There are so many things going on around the world today. So many believers also, so-called believers, they are pulling down themselves. They are pulling down their fellow believers. It shouldn't be. God is speaking to you this week as you go and say, no, that's not what you should do. You should do. You should defend yourselves. You should defend yourself. Stand for yourselves. However, if such a person perhaps did something wrong, what should you do? Should you cast them away? Pray for them. Help them to come back to the cross. Intercede for them. That's one of your sacrifices. And then once they decide to come back, once they have met with the Lord again, and they have decided to come to the cross, embrace them. Embrace them. Encourage them. That's the word of the Lord for someone this week. However, there are so many people that will be listening to me this morning and do not understand what I'm saying. That's because you are not part of the children of God. If you want to enjoy the grace that we enjoy, look at what the Bible says in that book of Acts chapter number 4, from verse 34. The Bible says the Spirit of God was so powerful over them. If you want to express the power of God in your life, as an unbeliever, you need to cross over that bridge to become a believer. And you know, that's when the power of God will begin to function in your life. And then you have this heart to sacrifice. And you have the heart to defend your fellow brethren. I wanted to give you a chance this morning. If you have not received Jesus into your heart, And you're going to encounter the power that Jesus Christ has released on his spirit. You want to encounter the power that caused the apostle to win 3,000 souls for God. And you want to encounter the heart to be sacrificial. If you have not given your life to Christ and you want to encounter that power that will help you to release everything you have, that will help you to defend God, and that will help you to defend your fellow brethren in whatever circumstances, that's what we call selflessness. Selflessness. It's only Jesus that can give you that heart. And that is why it is pertinent for believers to have that, because they have already received Jesus as their Lord and Savior. But if you have not, all right, and you want to enjoy this heart, this act, you want to enjoy this attitude, you want to enjoy this lifestyle, bow your heads with me and say this prayer. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I believe you died on the cross of Calvary. I believe you rose from the dead to save me. Write my name in the book of life and erase my name in the book of death. Be my Lord and my Savior. Come and live inside of me as from now henceforth. I will serve you till the end of the day. Help me to live righteously. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. If you have said that prayer, God bless you. God bless you. I love you. I would like to hear from you, and I would like to hear your encounter with the Lord. I believe the Lord is already in your heart right now and is reshaping your heart and is rebuilding you to the full stature of our Lord Jesus Christ. That is why I would love to hear from you, and I would love to pray with you, and I love to pray for you at all times. Please send me your name and your number on the number and email showing you on the screen right now, and I'll be glad to send you Bible, literature books, and manuals that will help you to grow in grace and into the stature of our Lord Jesus Christ. I would love to hear from you. Please send me your number, your name, and I would love to know you better. God bless you. And for all the persons that are listening to me and you have already received Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, and for some reason you are not having this heart of sacrifice, and for some reason you find it difficult to release your son, and you find it hard to release the land, and you find it hard to release your voice, and you find it hard to release that precious thing that you are holding on to, Jesus is speaking to you this week. The Holy Spirit is quickening your body inside of you, is speaking into your spirit man, and is reshaping you again and giving you the heart of flesh, so that as from now henceforth, whenever you see the need for the kingdom, you'll be the first to do it. Whenever you see a brethren of yours being pushed away, you will be the first to draw them close. That is the word of the Lord to you this week. As you go this week, the Lord will reshape your heart. The Lord will reshape your mind. The Lord will transform you into the full stature of our Lord Jesus. Thereby, when you see the need for the gospel to be spread, when you see the need for the things of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord will give the heart to sacrifice. When you see your neighbors, your brethren, your brothers and sisters in the Lord being pushed away, the heart to defend them, the Lord will release upon you. You have been engraved in the palm of the Lord's hand. Therefore, the life of Christ is embedded inside of you. Therefore, I pray for you. As you go this week, the life of Christ will emanate in you. The life of Christ will spring forth in you. And you begin to live godly living. And your life will be an example to others as you go. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. God bless you. I'll see you again next week. Bye for now.